Good evening. A random knock on the side of a container on the back of a truck has brought Australia's biggest manhunt to an end. Alleged drug kingpin Mostafa Baluch captured trying to sneak across the New South Wales-Queensland border. The fugitive had eluded police for weeks until one officer, with a hunch, brought it all undone.
Queensland Border Police approach a container, suspicious someone is hiding inside.
Armed police! Armed police!
Hands up in the car!
They score catch of the year. Inside is Sydney fugitive Mostafa Baluch. He's handcuffed and led to the gutter. In his backpack, wads of cash. His 2 weeks on the run at an end. Baluch giving up without a fight.
This is a great day for policing in Australia.
The 33-year-old had been hiding out in style in this high-end Mercedes SUV. It was concealed in the container, which was being carried on the back of a truck.
They noticed some suspicious items with the container that wasn't properly locked. It was other things that brought their attention.
Baluch had just crossed this border into Queensland and thought he was safe when the local constable who stopped the truck walked around to the side of the container, not realising his next move would crack the country's biggest case. He knocked on the container, never expecting a reply. The alleged drug kingpin knocked back, unwittingly giving himself up.
We suspect that the person inside the truck felt there was a drop-off point, that was being signalled that it was safe. He'd been there for some time, of course, it was the right time to get out. Didn't realise it was a constable.
Hours later, police arrested the truck driver, 46-year-old Yovanko Kidanovsky, near Grafton, before charging him with perverting the course of justice. This afternoon, detectives scouring the container and the Mercedes Baluch was found in for evidence. Baluch was granted bail in late October after being charged with trying to import 900 kilograms of cocaine into the country. But 3 days after getting out of jail, the 33-year-old cut off his electronic monitoring bracelet at Bayview. He was last seen on the M4 at Croydon, hiding on the back seat of a Range Rover before vanishing. Police believe he's been hiding in Sydney the whole time. Officers raiding safe houses at Yagoona and Potts Hill last Friday as they closed in on him.
He's looking at different options. We also looked at one in New South Wales, which was really well advanced, but he was desperate to leave Australia and join up with some colleagues overseas.
Police were determined that wouldn't happen, putting officers across the country on high alert. And in the end, it paid off.
I'm tracking down the constable that did the famous knock on the side of the truck. He'll get a beer and a hug from me when the borders open.
And our crime editor, Emma Partridge, is on the New South Wales-Queensland border for us tonight. Emma, good evening. What happens to Baluch now?
Pete, Baluch will spend custody on the Gold Coast before facing Southport Magistrates Court tomorrow. This is where the New South Wales Police will apply to have him extradited back to Sydney. As for the truck driver, Pete, he was refused bail at Grafton despite telling the court he had no idea that Baluch was a fugitive.
All right, Emma, thank you.